All right, so Lakshman, I'm working for one of the organization here, okay? So whenever we raise any request for any user creation in GFS, they first check whether the employee is created in system or not. So if the employee is not created, they deny the request. But then you said that it is not required anything. You know, we can simply input any of the username and we can create that user.
Correct, correct, correct. That's
So
true.
is that the customization we are following,
No,
or how is it?
it's not a customization. That is a standard process organizations follows. Okay. Reality. See how what they are doing, what we did. So now we just created a user, right? User we created and we assigned the required responsibilities. Now just we are learning. We are learning, that is the reason just we created user and we assigned. But reality in the organization will be accessing the application as a user, employee only, right? Organization point of view, you can create the user first. After that, the user will be used by whom? Say, the employee name is Lakshman. So the employee you have to create an HRMS application first. So when you send the request to so-and-so team, what you are mentioning, what they do is first they will verify. First of all, the user, what are the user requests they got, that employees exist in the organization or records, they'll verify. If employee exists, then only they'll treat as that is a valid user definition. So they'll create the user, they'll associate that employee with the user. This point also will be understanding, will be learning, will be doing later, but now not required. That is the reason we are not discussing. Now we cannot start with HRMS in this stage. So in the HRMS, how to create the employee, how to associate employee with the user, we'll discuss. Okay.
Okay, great. Yeah. So, yep. That's what I'm looking for.
Yeah, that is a point.
Yep.
But
Thanks a
without
lot.
employee association, you can create the user and you can start using. But primarily, there are certain transactions which you can perform within the application if employee is associated with the user. Otherwise, you cannot perform. But not all the transactions, the specific transactions. Take simple example, purchase order creation in the purchasing. If employee is not associated with the user, you cannot process the purchase orders. System will look for who is creating the purchase orders. Of course, somebody is creating by accessing the application, but that user is associated with which employee. The employee has which authority limits to create the purchase order and approve. All these information system will look for. And there are many other transactions which are connected with the employee association with the user. But when you talk about finance, yes, you can perform the transaction without employee association. And there are few transactions which system will look for when you talk about approvals. Okay. Reality, when you talk about organizations, the organizations normally they may create user instead of giving the employee name and all, employee ID. They'll just create employee ID. You may send the request to so-and-so team saying that just create user for the with this name, that may be employee ID. What they do, they'll go and verify that employee ID. With this employee ID, employees exist in the organization or not, they'll verify in the HRMS application. If that employee is working for the organization and the employee is an active employee, then only they'll create the user. Okay, they'll create the user, that employee, they associate with the user. That's how they'll give the access to specific responsibilities. So that user who is associated with the employee, they'll start working on the application. Okay, reality, this is
Okay,
a
but that would be a manual check.
yeah, that is a manual process. Yes, we have to do through manual process only. The same we'll be doing
Okay, fine.
going forward. Yeah, fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. So any other questions from anyone from the last from last session or prior sessions? So yesterday session, these are the tasks we performed, right? We created responsibility, we assigned primary ledger to responsibility, we created a user, we assigned responsibility to user. When we talk about responsibility creation, we created for general ledger application, that we created from system administrator responsibility, or call it as application. This is a navigation we followed. And to create the responsibility, how we created? By selecting the menu, data group and request group. And we assign primary ledger to responsibility by using GL ledger name profile option. For that, this is a navigation we used, profile system. So, and After performing the task, we created a user called as Apple, and this is the navigation we just take it, and what are the responsibility we created, that responsibility we assigned to this user. The same user we log into the instance and we reset the password and all these. This is what we did in the last session. Okay, in today's session what we'll do is, so now we have a user called as Apple, right? That user has access to only one responsibility. That responsibility is Apple General Ledger Super User. What is the menu name we used in the responsibility? We created a responsibility for GL. At the time of responsibility creation, we used one menu name for GL. What is the menu name? Anyone, please?
Super user.
GL Super User. What is the request group name?
General Ledger Concurrent Request.
Sorry, can you repeat?
General Ledger Concurrent Request.
GL Concurrent Program.
Yeah, GL Concurrent Program Group. Because that's how the name Oracle given. Yes, if you say General Ledger, yes, you are referring GL means. But when you talk about profile option names or menu names, and request group names, how Oracle provided as it is, we have to use. If I ask you the question, what is the profile option we can use to assign the primary ledger to responsibility? What is the profile option name?
GL ledger name.
Yeah, you have to say GL ledger name only. You should not say general ledger ledger name.
Okay.
People will find it as a new or something new they are hearing. Okay, so when you talk about profile options, menus, request groups, which are given by Oracle, how they named as this, we have to follow.
Okay.
So that's all about it. When you talk about applications, you can use, what are the financial applications? You can say GL, APR, CMFA, or else you can say general ledger, accounts payables, account receivables, cash management, fixed assets. Here nothing goes wrong. But when you talk about profile options, menus, request groups, etc., other names which are given by Oracle, we have to follow the same naming convention. Okay, the GL means general ledger, but the name, this is a name they given for profile option, we have to use the same terms. Done. Okay, so that's how just we created. And what is the data group name? We created responsibility that we used data group, right? What is the data group name?
Standard.
What do you mean by standard data group? What it refers?
Created from Oracle.
Database that belongs to general ledger application.
Yeah, standard means database name. That's all. Standard means database name. Again, within the database, where our responsible data need to be stored, that specification we give in a general ledger. That's all. So data group is nothing but database. We are referring the database name. Okay, that refers database. What do you mean by menu?
Menu contains functions, forms, and submenu.
Yeah, menu consists of submenus. Within the submenu, you can find the forms or call them as a functions or call as a features, but reality we call them as a functions. You can say menu consists of functions. The functions only you can find, those are grouped into submenus. Simply you can say menu consists of functions. Those functions only classified into submenus. What do you mean by request group?
Request group contains a list of concurrent programs related to the specific module.
Yeah, in very general terms you can use to explain about request group. Yeah, whatever you said, that is 100% true. But any other way of, any other definition you can give for request group? What do you mean by request group?
Group of concurrent programs or report?
Yeah, report, use the term. Yeah, concurrent programs, more technical application terminology. As we discussed, The request group, it consists of reports and programs. Okay, simply you can see in this stage, simply reports. Request group consists of reports. That's all. Okay, so menu, data group and request group. Okay, so out of these three, how many are mandatory?
Menu and
data groups are mandatory. Request group is optional. Without request group also, we can create the responsibility. Okay, fine. So anyone can list out the flex field qualifiers, please. Like how many flex field qualifiers we have, what are those? Anyone? We'll just spend 10 minutes time for these discussions, then directly we'll jump into the further discussions and the system related tasks. I could notice you are answering in the very beginning of the classes. You are taking initiative. Okay, let someone take this question.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah,
we have five, Lakshman.
I'm not sure. I am asking the question. Flex field qualifiers. How many? How what are them?
Six.
Six flex field qualifiers. What are those?
Balancing segment flex field qualifier. Cost center. Natural echo.
Yeah, please go ahead.
I think in the sequence I remember all of these three.
You can refer your note and you can answer also, right? After answering any kind of discussion, you can go on mute. Yeah, please. Anyone, please? What are the six flex field qualifiers we have?
It's balancing segment, natural account, call center, intercompany, and secondary tracking. One more is management.
Segment flex field qualifier.
Flex.
Okay. What is the use of a natural account segment flex field qualifier? We discussed.
We can.
We cannot. We can.
We can give that account name, account number. We can generate account number.
Wrong. Anyone, please? We'll say, spend just 10 minutes for this discussion. It's not more than that. So anyone, please, what is the use of natural account segment flex field qualifier? Every point, please make a note, read and remember. That's very, very important for this kind of functional courses. Anyone, please.
It is a behavior of account. Which account, like expense account or?
No, what? My question is what it will do. What is the use I am asking? What is the use we discussed? That is the reason I am asking this question. So what is the
by using that natural account, we can check which transaction it comes under, which account. Like,
yeah, correct. You are just very close to the actual point, but that is not enough information. Anyone, please.
Natural account will add some quality and some eligibility to which the to the account segment.
See, the point is, yeah, okay, your account segment you mentioned. Normally, qualifiers means it will add some behavior. It will set some behavior for something. That depending on which qualifiers will do it. When you talk about natural account segment flex field qualifier, what is the use? Why we are using the natural account segment flex field qualifier? Why we are assigning the account segment? The point is very simple. We discussed
by using that natural.
Yeah, please go ahead.
By using that natural account, we can give like which transaction comes under which account. We can differentiate like account.
Okay. Yeah, fine. Okay. At the same point, almost we discussed. What we discussed is, So if you assign the natural account segment flex fill qualifier to any segment, it will add three segment qualifiers. That is the point we discussed. Okay, the natural account segment flex fill qualifier will add three segment qualifiers. We assign natural account segment flex fill qualifier to account segment. So that is the reason when you go to account related values, we are able to see five segment qualifiers. Every segment value we can find allow budgeting, allow posting. Because of natural account segment flex fill qualifier, we can see five segment qualifiers for account segment. That means natural account segment flex fill qualifier is adding account type, third party control account and reconcile. These three segment qualifiers, natural account segment qualifier will add to account segment values. This is the point we discussed. Okay. So what is the use of management segment flex fill qualifier? There should not be any answer because we didn't discuss. Okay, primarily we discussed about natural account segment flex fill qualifier. Balancing also, I just given few points, but let it be. There is a time to discuss about those, the purpose of balancing segment flex fill qualifier. Okay, fine, done. So what is the use of allow dynamic inserts?
It will allow to create code combination automatically, dynamically.
Okay. Any other answer?
It will allow new combinations, code combinations.
Yeah, that is the point. If you ignore term called as new, answer is 50% answer. Okay. It will allow to create combinations means, no, it is not just to allow code combinations. It is to allow new code combinations. Okay. That is a point what we discussed. And what do you mean by retained earnings account?
It tells you what the total amount is. So after your revenue minus your liability, that gives you if the company is in profit or loss.
Yes. Any other definition? What do you mean by retained earnings account?
So net earning of the business.
Yes. Any further information on that? Just as a simple line of definition.
Total profit of the company.
Okay. So what we discussed is retained earnings.
Revenue minus expense.
Nothing but surplus account. The revenue minus expense goes to retained earnings. The same, if you remember, that is enough. Okay, even if we try to explain a lot of information, finally that should get connected to the point what we are discussing. If you remember what we are discussing, that's more than enough. Okay, you no need to explain a lot of other stuff to bring that summary of point what we are discussing. Okay, just remember as is what we are discussing, that would be enough. If you try in your own way, that makes some confusion, that may like the clarity may miss when somebody is taking that point. Okay, maybe from our side that may be fine, but whatever we are discussing, take that point and use as is. That is more than enough who are trying to understand your level of knowledge. Okay, so that is the reason I am requesting each and every point make a note. Each and every point make a note, read and remember the same. If somebody is going to ask the question, deliver the same point. Just talk about the same point. Still, if they are asking, give me some example, then you can talk on top of it, some other stuff you can bring and you can talk about it. Once you understand the concept, rest of things you'll be able to just describe. You can elaborate on that. Okay. If somebody is going to ask you the question, what do you mean by retained earnings account? The simple answer is, It's a surplus account. The revenue minus expense goes to retained earnings account. You may add other point. The retained earnings account is a mandatory account. We have to provide it within the primary ledger. When you create the primary ledger, we have to provide the retained earnings account. I may ask you the question, okay, when you create the retained earnings account, we provide only one company. What about other companies? How to, like, for retained earnings, we are providing only one company. What about other companies? How to specify other companies? What is your answer?
So it will consider all companies retained earnings.
Sorry?
It will not consider the company segment.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't get you.
No, what I'm saying, it will not consider the first segment, company segment is there. No, it will not consider that one. It will take only that retained earnings account.
Yeah, correct. Your answer, the same answer I'll say in this way. So my question is, we are providing only one company. What about other companies? The answer should be, we no need to provide any company over there. So based on the transaction system, we'll calculate the retained earnings account, retained earnings, not based on the company which you are providing in the retained earnings account field. Since the account is mandatory, since the company is mandatory, we are providing company. There you can choose any one of the company, because of that company system is not going to calculate retained earnings. So always system will calculate the retained earnings based on the transactions which you have. It will look at the expense and revenue. Based on that, it will calculate the retained earnings. So this is how we have to explain. The same. I am just presenting in the different way. That's all. Okay, this is how. Please get ready to answer for any sort of question what we already completed. So, and again, when we are going to answer, it has to be very simple. So it has to be very simple. You don't need to explain too much to present simple point. Okay, the first point is we have to deliver that answer in the just simple line. On top of it, if you want to explain with the examples and all, you can do that. But the total explanation should not bring summary of the answer. Okay, done. Okay. Just going forward, maybe after one or two sessions, we'll have a simple test also on the topics. By the time whatever we cover, I'll be sharing one FAQ, questionnaire, and you can answer and you can revert back to us. And we'll discuss on that, how you are presenting reality, how that should be presented, how we have to, what points we have to consider, what we no need to consider. Those points we'll discuss so that will become good information for us to understand, and when you go for interview or when you speak with others about this kind of topics or subject or whatever, that can be useful for us. Okay, we'll do that. Fine, done. So we have this user. The user has access to this responsibility. Now I want to create the transaction. When you talk about transactions, say we have a general ledger, GL, we have AP, we have AR, we have CM, FA, and many other applications. We don't need to take all the applications for example. So we'll go with these. So what transactions you can record in the AP? Anyone please?
Payable transactions. All expense items?
We discussed. We discussed in the P2P cycle. If you remember, you can answer those. Simple.
All expense items.
Okay. What we discuss, what sort of transactions we can record in AP? Anyone, please. Use the same terminology, whatever we discussed.
Purchase invoices.
What else?
Debit note and
payments. We discuss any debit note, credit note, etc. Right? Your answer is 100% right, but we didn't discuss those points. Okay. So in AP, we can record purchase invoice and payments. As a part of purchase invoice only, we'll be having all the notes. Okay. This is what we discussed. In AR, which transactions we record?
Sales invoice
and the
Receipt.
That's all. These points are more than enough when we talk about these applications. When we start working on that, we'll get to know many. What are the different type of purchase invoices? What are the different type of payments? What are the different type of sales invoices, receipts and all, we'll understand. Okay, for now, in AP, which transactions we can record? Primarily purchase invoice and payments, and here, sales invoice and receipts. There's a purpose for purchase invoice and payment in the same way. Based on the purpose, we are recording the different transactions, the different applications. But in the GL, any transaction you record in the GL, that simply we call as journal. Okay, any transaction you record in the GL, that we call as journal. Okay, so reality, we'll create the transaction in the subledger applications. Already we discussed this point. Other than GL, all applications we call as subledger applications. Okay, all applications we call as subledger applications other than GL. So the reality, we record the transactions in subledger applications only. The finally, the data we will send to GL. When this data will come to GL, the data will be considered journal. The purchase invoice information will be transferring to GL. Within the GL, the purchase invoice information you can see as a journal. The payment information will be sending to GL for reporting purpose. The payment information in GL you can see as a journals, but in AP you can see as a payment. So this purchase invoice information will send to GL. That record will be called in the GL as a journal, but in AP you can see as a purchase invoice. In the same way, as per AR sales invoice, once you send the data to GL, that we call as journal. Any transaction data we send to GL, that is called as a journal. Okay, journal. Journal means the day-to-day transaction. The day-to-day transaction you can record as a journal. Okay, so that is the meaning of journal. So when you are working for any client, the client, what they do is, if they spend some expense, they'll be recording in the payables. If they purchase something, the against the purchaser's purchase invoice, they record in the payables and they'll process the payments. If they do some sales activity against the sales, they record the sales invoice, and once they receive the payment from customer, they record as a receipt. But what about GL? GL, we don't use GL to record the day-to-day business transaction directly in the GL. We don't record any business transaction directly in the GL. From all the subledger application, data goes to GL. Only in the GL side, we can enter some adjustment entries. Okay, some sort of adjustment entry. What sort of adjustment entries and all, we'll discuss. For now, just for understanding, we'll see how to create the journal in GL. Okay, we'll see how to create the journal in GL. Create journal in GL, general ledger application. Okay, so within the GL, for GL responsibility, what we assign? Primary ledger. Okay, for GL responsibility, we assign primary ledger. So if you want to record the transaction, I mean to say GL, journal, if you want to record the journal in the GL application or GL responsibility, you have to record the journal in specific period, right? So today date is August 28th. If you want to record the transaction, you can record in August month on 28th. So if you want to record the transaction in primary ledger, in any primary ledger, in which period you want to record the journal, the period should be open. Say there is one room, if you want to enter inside, the door should be open. If door is closed, we cannot enter. In the same way, what are the periods we have in our accounting calendar? In any period, if you want to record any transaction or call as a journal, any transaction you want to enter in any period, the period should be open. The period status should be open. If period status is open, then only you can record the transaction within that period. Now, if you want to create the journal in GL, GL means within the GL, by using the primary ledger only we can record the transaction. Within the primary ledger we have calendar, within the calendar we have periods. In which period you want to record the transaction, the period should be open. Once the period is open, within that period, on specific date, you can record the transaction. Okay, this is the point we have to understand. So now if you want to record the journal within the GL, we have to open the GL period. Open GL period. Okay, we have to open the GL period. Once you open the GL period, okay, which GL period we have to open? Current period we have to open. Current period is August. If you open the August, within the August, by selecting any date, you can create the journal. Okay, so fine. You are going to create one journal. Journal you are creating just first to record some expense. Okay, you created. After creating the journal, say some expense journal you created. How to create journal we'll see in the system. Before that we'll try to understand few points. Okay, the first point is, if you want to create the journal in the GL, first you have to open the GL period. GL period means, to this GL application or say responsible, what are the primary ledger we assigned, within that primary ledger what are the accounting calendar we have, within that accounting calendar we have to open the current period. Open GL period, nothing but open current period. Have to open the current period. So then you can go and create the expense journal, which expense you spent, how much you paid or how much you have to pay, you may record within the expense journal. After recording, you have to post the journal. We have to create the journal, we have to post it. When you create the journal, within the journal will give some expense account and cash account and some other accounts. What are the accounts the journalist belongs to, which accounts, accordingly we will provide the accounts. Say for example, you are entering expense journal by giving so and so expense. Say admin expense is 5000 rupees. The 5000 rupees need to be maintained against the account which you are giving in the expense journal. So when you create the journal, within the journal you can see account and you can see the amount, but this amount should go under that account, whatever the account we specified in the journal. For that, what we have to do is, we have to post the journal. Simple point. Say you are just filling some online application. You are filling some online application. You fill some data. You saved it. And there will be final action called as submit. If you don't submit that application, do you find any use of filling that application? Answer is no. Okay, you may fill, once you save, that may be saved in the draft mode. Finally, if you submit, that request will get submitted. For what purpose you are filling that application? The same logic here. You can create the journal and you can save, but no use. Until unless you post the journal, okay, system won't update the balances with the relevant accounts. So what are the points we are discussing now? We'll go and see so that we can understand. Okay, now what we have to do, we are ready with the user and responsibility. Now we are going to perform three tasks. The first task is open GL period. First we have to open the GL period. The second step, create journal. After creating, we have to post the journal. So before we go and do this activities in the system, any question from anyone, please? Okay, reality we don't create journals in the GL, only some sort of adjustment entries we may pass, but to understand how to create the journal in the GL, we are going to perform this transaction. Okay, user has access to this responsibility. Now we'll go to that responsibility. Within that response, to that responsibility, whatever the primary ledger is associated, within the primary ledger, whatever the accounting calendar we have, that accounting calendar, within that accounting calendar, we have to open the current period. So that system will allow us to create the journal. If you want to create the journal in the current period, if period is not open, you cannot enter any transaction. So after creating, we have to post the journal. If you post, then only the balances will get updated against the accounts which you are going to specify within the journal. These points we'll understand by performing. Okay, fine. Now we'll just go to this responsibility and we'll just do one by one. So any questions from anyone to understand these points, please? Anyway, we will do then you'll get more clarity on that. Before that, any questions, please? I'm just closing which we opened yesterday. So username is Apple and provide the password. Fine. So this user has access to only one responsibility. Expand. Just open this responsibility by clicking on any one of the function. Click on any one of the function, system will open that responsibility with the navigator. You can close which function we selected to open this, then close. Now the responsibility name is Apple General Ledger Super User. So within that, this is a navigator, right? So now what we are going to do? So first we have to open the GL period. Take the navigation. Please make a note of all these points. Okay. So first we have to open the GL period. Take the navigation. So GL period we can open from the GL responsibility only. So navigation is setup, open or close. Okay. Open, if you open the period, system will allow you to enter the transaction. Now say current period is August. Once we entered into September month, we no need to record the transactions in August, right? So once we entered into September month, we have to close previous month. Otherwise, users can record the transaction in the previous month. Say now we are in August. Before we entering into August, the prior period, July month, we have to close. We close July month, then we'll open the August month. Once we just move to September month, we have to close the August month and we have to open the September month. So only we have to keep open current period so that users can record the transactions only in the current period. If you don't close previous periods, system will allow the business users to record the transaction. To have a control on the system process, always we have to close the previous periods. We have to keep open only current period. This rule is applicable in all the applications, not only in the GL, APR, CMF, and all the applications. In which applications you record the transactions, always you have to make sure that current period is only open. You should not keep open previous periods. Okay, so that will create many issues, and why we have to close those points also we'll be discussing. There are some other points also which we have to understand. Now to open the GL period, navigation is setup, open or close. That means this function only will use to open as well as to close also. Double click. So we want to open the periods which are in this accounting calendar, which are in this ledger, right? Within this ledger only we have accounting calendar. So within that accounting calendar, what are the periods we have? Out of that, we want to open the current period. Just click on find. Before that, we'll discuss one point. What is the first period in our accounting calendar?
April.
The reason is, We created accounting calendar for India. By following yes, India financial year, we created our accounting calendar. The first period is April.
Yes,
so now the same system will display. Just click on find. So system is showing the first period is April. Which period we want to open?
August month.
August month, current month, but the first period is April. Without opening the prior periods, you cannot open directly August month. Okay. without opening the prior periods, we cannot open current period. So when you do the implementation first time, we have to open the all prior periods, then only system will allow us to open the current period. It's only one time at the time of implementation we do this. After that, user will start entering the transaction. Once they move to the next period, they'll be closing that previous period and they'll open the next period. So that's how we'll manage these periods. Okay, so when you do the implementation first time, this process we have to follow. We have to open all the periods from the first period to current period. Once you open your current period, you can close previous periods. Why we are opening? Because without opening the previous periods, we cannot open the current period directly. That is the reason we are opening. Once we just open our current period, previous periods you can close. Anyway, we are not going to record the transaction in the previous periods. Our target is entering the transaction from the current period. Okay. So within this ledger, we have accounting calendar. Within the accounting calendar, the first period is April. The same system is showing. You just say open. Now the request will be submitted to concurrent manager. We discussed if you are performing any important tasks, the task need to be submitted to concurrent manager. The task, or you can say concurrent request, whatever the request we submit to concurrent manager, that is concurrent request we call. Just click on yes. Are you sure you want to open this first period in our ledger? Okay, in our ledger, this period you want to open as a first period? Yes, because that only first, that April 18 only is the first period in our accounting calendar. So you have to say yes. It will submit the request to concurrent manager. Say okay. If you want to go and see the request, you can go to view, request, find. So system submitted open period request to concurrent manager to open the first period within this accounting calendar, within this primary ledger. So what is the name? From where system is taking this name? Anyone please? We discussed. We have to remember all these points. This name we have seen.
Prime name of ledger.
Sorry?
Primary ledger.
Yes, exactly. That is the point. Short name of the primary ledger. We didn't provide it, right? System taken. What is the meaning of this combination? What is this number?
I think that is a ledger ID.
Ledger ID.
Yeah, that is a ledger ID. That's what we discussed. So system, we given the ledger name, system created ledger short name. How it created ledger short name? By taking around 10 to 13 characters, around 11 or 13 characters. It takes from ledger name and it will take the ledger ID and it will take ledger currency. With the combination of ledger name, ledger ID, ledger currency, system created short name for the ledger that we just discussed also, right? After creating the ledger, we opened the ledger and we gone through this information. So if you remember that, here easily you can catch it. Done. Anyway, just click on refresh so that system will update the status. So the request is completed. Okay, now close it. Now this is the open close periods window, right? Now this window also you can close. This form also you can close. Just reopen the same form. You can see the period as open. The first period system will show as a open. So same navigation. Take the same navigation. Setup. Open or close. Open or close is the function name. But now we are navigating to that form to open the period only. We'll see how to close also. Now click on find. You can see April period status is open. That means now you can go and record the transactions in the April month. But we are in August month. We don't need April month. So now we have to open the August month. So here we have open next period tab. If you click on that, next period is May. System will open the May. Again, if you click on open next period, it will open June. Again, if you click on open next period, July, August, that's how one by one periods it will open. Instead of opening one by one, what you can do is you can click on open target period. What is our target period? Current period is our target period. Okay. Hope this is clear to everyone. This is a navigation setup. Open or close. Click on find. The first period we submitted to concurrent manager to open. The same you can see the period status is open. So what is the future entry and all we'll discuss. There are many other statuses also. Okay. For now, just the target is opening the period. Other points from where system is taking this and all we'll be discussing. We have relevant topics to understand those. In the GL side, we have a concept called as period statuses. At that time, we'll discuss. For now, that is no other information required for us. So April period is open. But our target period is current month. So to open the current month, click on open target period. You give the target period. August, just type August, it will take automatically the period name. So now if I say open this August month, what system will do is first period is April. After this April, we have May. From May to August, all the period system will open automatically. Otherwise, you can click on one by one to open. You don't need to do this. You have a simple option. So open first period, then just click on open target period, select current period, then from the first period, means anyway first period is open, from the next period to current period, all the period system will open. Okay, just click on open period. So are you sure you want to open the current this period as a target period? Yes. The request will be submitted to concurrent manager. You can go to which window this is? What is the name for this window we discussed? What is this window name?
SRS window.
What do you mean by SRS?
Standard request submission.
Standard request submission. Okay. So click on refresh. It takes some time. Reason? It has to open multiple periods, right? It has to open May, June, July, August. So that is the reason system takes some time to open one by one. See, I am asking simple questions. If you are not answering, if you are not able to answer, you have to think on it. Just click on refresh data so that the request will be processed as soon as possible. If you don't click on refresh data, that would be completed, but takes its own time. If you click on this, that means we are hitting the concurrent manager saying, please complete as soon as possible. So that's how the concurrent manager, our force, the request will be completed, okay, by concurrent manager. Okay, done. Now close this form and reopen. You don't need to just minimize it. Directly you can click on open close, but just I am doing that. Here we have collapse all, setup, open or close. Now click on find, you can see up to August period, all periods are open. Do we need these previous periods? We don't require. We are going to record the transaction. You can leave as is, no issues. But if you think, so we don't want to allow any user to record the transaction, the previous periods, you can close them. Okay, you can set close. So select close. Just set close option, close status. And save it. Now users cannot record the transactions in these previous periods. Reason we set these periods status as a closed. Only August month is open. So we set the status, right? When you try to close this form, system will submit the request to concurrent manager. That means as this period status is closed, this need to be updated to concurrent manager. See, when you click on close, submitted four concurrent requests for four periods. For four periods, we change the status. So that is the reason four requests will be submitted to concurrent manager. Concurrent manager will make a note as these four periods are closed. You can go to SRS window, you can see. System submitted four requests for four periods. You
and click on refresh. So this is a reporting sequence is separate future. Okay, we have in our course curriculum that on topic also we have. When we are working on GL, we'll discuss about it. Now just look at the point. We just close the period, system is running these programs. That's all. Okay. These requests not required for us. That is related to separate future, which we have in the GL side. When we are working on GL, that we'll understand. Okay, we close the periods. Done. Now, GL period status is open. If GL period status is open, we can record the journals. Okay, now we'll just see how to create the journal. Okay, how to create the journal. So we have to go with the navigation. What is the navigation? Here, what is the navigation we followed? You have to remember the navigations. To open the periods in GL, what is the navigation? Setup.
Setup and open.
Open or close. Okay, I'll say setup, open or close. Now we have to create the journal. Please make a note what is the navigation for journal creation. To create the journal, navigation is journals, enter. Please make a note. To create the journal, navigation is journals, enter. So reality, we don't create the journals in GL. Only some sort of adjustment journal entries only we create within the GL. The real business transactions always will create in the respective application. If the transaction belongs to payables department, we'll record within the accounts payable application. If the transactions belongs to asset department, we have to record within the fixed assets application, not in the GL. Okay, but we have to understand how to create the journal also. So that is the reason we are going to see the process of journal creation. It's very simple. Okay, journals, enter. So that is the navigation we have to take. Now we are going to create the new journal. So click on new journal. Click on new journal. Okay, click on new journal. And before we go and create the journal, we'll talk about journal structure. Okay, journal structure. We discussed about chart of account structure, right? What is the chart of account structure? Structure name, under the segments, under segment, segment values. That is the structure for chart of account. In the same way, journal has a structure. It's a very simple structure. The total journal information is classified into two parts, header part and lines part. The header level, okay, so this is the journal structure, header and lines. When you are creating the journal, there will be header information and the lines information. So as a part of header, what information we provide? We provide the journal name and we have to specify. We are creating the journal in which ledger? Ledger means primary ledger. The journal, what is the journal? We are creating journal name. And in which ledger we are going to create the journal? The ledger name, nothing but primary ledger name. And again, we are going to create the journal in which period? And in which date within that period? We are going to create the journal in August month. And August month, in August month, on which date? 28th. Again, the journal we are going to create in which currency? Okay, in which currency? There will be a lot of information to understand. So, based on the transaction which we record, we'll get to know those information. For now, these are the simple information we have to understand. Header level will provide the journal name. And again, the journal we are going to create in which primary ledger? Okay, the primary ledger name. And the journal we are creating in which period? And what is the date, and again in which currency we are going to create the journal, that information we have to provide. So line level we have to provide the accounting information. accounting information. Accounting information means along with account, our other segment values. So in our chart of accounts, we have three segments: company, department, account. So those segment values only will provide as a code combinations in the line level. Okay, and we will provide the amount also primarily. Okay, line level. So we'll provide the accounting information. Accounting information is nothing but code combination. Okay, code combination information and amount. So debit, credit. If you are not aware of what is the meaning of debit and credit, just wait for some time, you'll understand. For now, just see and do. Just to try to take those points, what we are doing, that's all. Okay, you don't need to worry about debits and credits if you are not aware of those, what is the meaning of debit and credit. Okay, slowly we'll get to know all those points if you are new to those terms. Done. Okay, this is what we are going to do. So this is a journal structure, header and line information. The total journal information is classified and maintained, okay, as a within the header and lines. The total journal information is classified as a header information, lines information. Header level will provide the journal name and ledger, nothing but primary ledger, and period, date, currency. Line level will provide a code combination, nothing but accounting information, and will enter the amount also. So the amount is belongs to which currency, that you can see in the header level. So whenever you create the journal with the header and line, automatically system will create the batch for each journal. Okay, every journal system will treat as one batch. Okay, it will treat as a batch. That is a point we have to understand. Every journal creation system will treat as a one batch. Okay, batch means there should be multiple journals, but here reality system will consider each journal as a one batch. Okay, so these are the points we have to understand. We'll go on to see how to create the journal. Okay, fine. So what is the navigation to create the journal? Journals, enter. This is the navigation. To create the new journal, you have to click on the tab called as new journal. This is journal creation form. Okay, within this form you can create the journal. So just now we discussed journal structure is, I mean the total journal is structured as a header and lines. So where is a header and where are lines? So here lines tab we have, right? Above two lines, the total above section we call as a header. So this section we call as header. And under lines tab, whatever the section we have, that we call as lines. So header part, lines part. Okay, first we'll see how to create the journal. So here you can provide the journal name. Say just you can record any journal. Say for example, you want to pay the salaries. Okay, you want to pay the salaries to the employees. In that case, you can take salaries. Journal name is salaries. Reality, we don't create any salaries related journals in GL. Those has to be processed in the payroll application. But the salaries information will come to GL as a journal only. But here for our understanding, to know how to create the journal, we are creating the journal. Okay, so slowly you'll be understanding many things. You'll get more clarity, you'll get complete understanding. But here the target is how to create journal. We are trying to do it. Fine. Provide the journal name. Okay, so system is taking the ledger name as Apple India Primary Ledger. How system is taking, anyone, any guess on this? How system know we need a Apple India Primary Ledger?
Based on the responsibility we used.
What do you
have set the
based on responsibility?
Profile option for the responsibility. Because we have set the profile option for the responsibility.
Yes. We assigned one primary ledger to our responsibility. Within that responsibility, wherever you go, go to any form, if you find the field called as ledger, automatically system will take that ledger name which is assigned to that responsibility. So we assigned, okay, we assigned primary ledger to this responsibility, right? Apple, general ledger, super user. We are within that responsibility only, right? Within that responsibility, anything you want to create, automatically system will display the same ledger name. So that's how it is taking. Now system is taking period as August. How system is taking the period as August?
Because only this period is open.
If I go and open September, system will take September or August?
August only. Because of the accounting calendar.
No. My question is, system is taking August 2018. Because August 2018 is open as a current period. If I go and open the September month, which period system will take? It will take the current period or future period?
Future period.
Sorry?
Future period.
Yeah, I'm asking your guess only. This point we didn't discuss. Future period. Yes, exactly correct. So the point is, what system will do is, system won't bother about what is the real actual period we are in. System always will take the latest open period within the accounting calendar. In our accounting calendar, the latest period, we opened August only, because we are in August month. If you go and open up to December, okay, the December is the last latest period which we open in our accounting calendar. When you create the journal, it will select December month only. Okay, system won't look at what is the current period for reality. It won't look at it. Always it will look at which is the latest open period, which is the last period open in our accounting calendar. That only it will take. But always system will take the current period. Reason is, we don't open the future periods. Always will open up to current period only. Okay, so that is the reason system is taking the August month. And it is taking automatically date. Since these periods are matching, so whatever the period, the latest period which is open in our accounting calendar is August, and the actual period also August. So that is the reason today date only it is taken. Okay, if you open September month, here it will take September month, and it will take date as a 1st of September only. That's how it will take. But reality, we don't do that. Fine, automatically system is taking. Okay, here we given the journal name, and the system is selecting primary ledger, because which primary ledger is assigned to that responsibility, that primary ledger system selects. And the system is taking the period. How it is taking the August month? Because the latest open period in our accounting calendar is August month. That is the reason it is taking. It is not considering the real period which is selected in our system. Okay. And currency. It is taking INR. From where it is taking this INR? From this ledger. Within the ledger, we given the ledger currency or functional currency as INR, right? Within the ledger, whatever the currency we given, that you can call as ledger currency. So within this primary ledger, we selected at the time of ledger creation, we selected a currency called as INR. The same system is selecting here. Just try to understand these points only, what we are discussing, because just to introduce how to create the journal, we are just trying to create this, going through this information. So when we are working on general ledger application, we'll understand all these points, category, etc., etc. There are many options which you have to understand. We'll be covering all those. Okay, for now the point is, the header level, which information we are providing, what information we are providing, just we given journal name only, remaining information system is selecting automatically, ledger system is selecting, period system is selecting, effective date system is selecting, currency also system is selecting, rest of information also system is selecting, but not required for us now to understand. Okay, done. So this is all about header. If you don't give the journal name, automatically it will create the journal name. Automatically system will create the journal name. That will come to know when we do the testing accordingly. Okay, fine. Anyway, we given the name, the same name system will take. Now here we have a lines. Go to lines, place cursor in the line number. Here just provide the number for the line. This is the line 1. Within the journal, we are creating the first line. So here account is nothing but a chart of accounts. chart of accounts means within the chart of accounts, not only account, we have many other segments. So account is important segment. So that is the reason the name they are representing as account. Here we have to provide the code combination. Click on LOV. So within this primary ledger, what are the chart of accounts you have? That chart of accounts segments you can find from here. Click on LOV. So within this primary ledger, so this is a chart of account we have. Apple Accounting Flex Field. Apple Accounting Flex Field. Within that we have three segments. At the time of segment creation, we given the segment name. If you tab out, automatically the same segment name system copied as a window prompt. Window prompt is nothing but this. This is a window. Within that the prompt, the field prompt, the display name. There if you give the company name as segment, you can give as a company. Once you tap, system will copy the same name as a window prompt. If you change the window prompt to Apple company, here display would be Apple company, Apple department. Your segment name will be company. Window prompt, how you maintain, accordingly system will display. So the window prompt field, whatever we have seen at the time of segments creation, that name will be displayed here. Now select company. So we are going to pay salaries, for example, this company is going to pay salaries. Select company, any one of the company just for testing, which department is going to pay, say HR department or any department you can select. Account, what we are going to pay, salaries. Select salaries account. So debit this account, say 1 lakh, also 10 lakhs. Okay, enter debit. So salaries we are paying, what we are paying, salaries. Okay, as we paid, we have to just provide the cash account. Okay, so go to LOV. So that is a company, select HR department. Okay, and select cash account. Selected. And the credit amount also same. Okay, 10 lakhs. Now if you notice, we are recording the transaction. We are recording the transaction. When we are recording the transaction as in the form of journal, what system has to do is as per accounting. So the debit line should be equal to credit. That means that debit amount should be equal to credit amount. Okay, that is fine. Not only that, the amount is getting debited for which company, the same amount should be credited for the same company. That means debit amount, credit amount should be equal. Debit amount should be equal to credit amount for the same company. Here we have 1000, 1000. Okay, cool. So if I take company as a 2000 for credit, that means debit amount is equal to credit amount, but not for same company. As per accounting rule, debit should be equal to credit for the same company. Okay, you should not record like for this company 1000, this is salaries expense, but the company 2000 is paying. So those are some intercompany transactions within the organization. Some adjustment entries you can pass, but real transaction you should not pass in this way. Okay, now what I'll try to do is I'll try to save it. System saved this record. After creating the journal, what we have to do? We have to post it, right? We have to post it. So here is a tab called as post. Just click on post. Here you just go to, we are under lines tab, go to other information tab. Here see the posting status as unposted. Yes, this journal is unposted. Okay, now can we change the account, the amount, journal name, date and all you can change. Once you post this journal, everything will be freezed. Now I will try to post it. Click on post. The request will be submitted to concurrent manager. What concurrent manager will do? Concurrent manager will verify the journal is created properly or not. We'll just say okay. go to SRS window to see the status of journal posting request. So this request will go to the concurrent manager. Okay, concurrent manager will validate that journal. This journal cannot be posted. Okay, we'll see that. Let's wait for some time. Okay, see the status, the concurrent manager given the warning. Okay, warning. Now you can go with the view output, that is also not required here. Directly you can go to journal. This is journal, right? Just copy the journal name. How to keep the form in the query mode?
F11.
F11. And paste the journal name, salaries. How to execute the query?
Control F11.
Control F11. Now go to other information tab and see the posting error. Error 10. What it says? Showing unbalanced. Okay. Unbalanced intra-company journal entry. Okay, showing unbalanced intra-company journal entry. Okay, if this transaction belongs to just within the organization, within the organization means which happens between the two companies, that will be treated as an intra-company. This is not intra-company journal, it is not getting balanced. So showing unbalanced. So what is the meaning of showing unbalanced? When you record any journal, okay, debit should be equal to credit for the same company. Same company. Here companies are different. Debit you take in company 1000, credit you take in company 2000. Amounts are equal, but not companies are equal. That means balance and segment values also should be equal. Okay, when you create the transaction within the journal, the debit should be equal to credit for the same balancing segment value. So this is the rule. This is the rule. So we assigned balancing segment flex field qualifier to company segment. Now what the balancing segment flex field qualifier will do is, the balancing segment qualifier always verify each and every transaction. The transaction is getting balanced with the debit and credit line with the same balancing segment value or not. Now balancing segment flex field qualifier we assign to company segment, and the balancing segment qualifier only verifying the debit and credit company is same or not. In debit and credit, companies are not same. That is the reason the concurrent manager is not allowing to post a journal by following the rule called as balancing rule. What balancing rule says? Debit should be equal to credit for the same balancing segment value. But here that rule violation we have. Who is looking after this rule? balancing segment flex fuel qualifier that we assign to company. So always company level, the transaction should get balanced. Here if you have 1,000, then debit 10 lakhs, credit 10 lakhs, and debit company 1,000, credit company 1,000, then it will be allowed for posting. Otherwise, this journal cannot be allowed for posting because of balancing segment flex fuel qualifier. That means what segment level you want to balance the transactions to prepare the reports, okay, that level we have to assign the balancing segment flex fuel qualifier. So that means balancing segment qualifier, always make sure that the transactions are getting balanced for the same company. If transaction is not getting balanced for the same company for debit and credit, it won't allow for posting. If system is not allowing for posting, there is no use of the transaction. There is no use of the transaction, just that is a record. So this amount cannot be updated against these accounts. This amount cannot be updated against these accounts to then produce the reports. Okay. So what is the use of balance and segment flex fuel qualifier? Balance and segment qualifier, always balance the lines. Okay, it will balance the debit and credit lines with respect to segment, for which segment you are assigning the balance and segment flex fuel qualifier. Here department can be different. In the debit you can take 2,000, credit you can take 3,000, system will allow to post. The rule is applicable only for company. For company only we assign balance and segment flex fuel qualifier. That is the use of balance and segment flex fuel qualifier. So it always verifies the debit and credit lines are getting balanced with the same company or not. Okay, this is the purpose of balancing segment flex fuel qualifier, why we assign to company segment. If I just take the company as 1,000, it will allow. You can take different department. Already you taken different accounts. You can take other segment values, any segment values, but company should be same. That is a balancing rule. That means by using the balancing segment flex fuel qualifier, we are implementing the balancing rule. What do you mean by balancing rule? You have to balance debit and credit lines with the same company. Okay, that is a balancing rule which we have in accounting. So that rule we are implementing by using the balance and segment flex fuel qualifier. Now I just corrected that account, the company to 1,000 only. Now submit for posting. It will be posted without any issue. Now it won't take much time also, it will finish as soon as possible. So now see, the status is normal and phase is completed. Now there is no issue with our journal now. Now the everything is proper and the transaction is getting balanced with the same balance and segment value. Now you can refresh this. Now you can copy the journal name, F11, paste the same name, control F11. Now see, the complete journal is freezed. That means posted. After posting, system won't allow to update. See the status, posting is posted. Okay, so this is how we have to create the journal and we have to post the journal. Okay, we'll understand more detail level about the journals when we work on GL application. Now we are not going to work on GL. So in the real time, what practice we follow, what points we have to understand, how to drive the complete system configuration processes, will go in that way. And finally, we'll just come back to GL, and there are many features within the GL. apart from journals and journal related. So all we'll be discussing at the time. You can understand more detail level. Even when you are working on subledger applications, also data flows into GL at the time. We'll come back to GL and we'll verify. So that's how there are many different ways which will help us to understand detail level this journal related records and other information related to GL. Okay, we'll be covering everything. But for now, the target is understanding how to create the journal. After creating the journal, how to post it, and what is the purpose of balancing segment flex field qualifier. We discussed about two flex field qualifiers, balancing your natural account. What is the purpose of balancing segment flex field qualifier? To balance each and every transaction. And natural account, to assign three additional segment qualifiers to account segment values. These 2 points you have to remember. Okay, other qualifiers we'll be discussing whenever those are required. So any questions from anyone on these points, please? And if you want to find the journal, whatever you created, say you are in the navigator, you want to find out the journal, simple. Go to journals, enter. So this is a find journal form. So we don't have many journals to filter and all, directly you can click on find. How many journals we have within our primary ledger, all system will display. See here, this is the name we given, journal name salaries, automatically system taken the same name as a batch name. Okay, just every journal system create as a batch. Okay, so we have a separate feature called as batch journals. When we work on GL, we'll be creating, then you can understand what is the meaning of batch. But even we created individual journal, that also system always treat as a batch only. That's how they just designed that transaction record definition. Fine. So if you want to open and see that journal, you can click on review journal. So what are the journal we created and posted, you can see. And we can go and inquire the account balances and all those, all we'll see when we are working on GL. Now not required. Only the simple basic understanding we require how to create the journal in GL. And just one the other point is, what is the use of balance and segment flex field qualifier, whatever we assign to company segment, that we have to understand. First we have to create the journal, then we have to post it. Once you post, the balances will get updated. Remember the point, what is the use of posting? To update the account balances, we have to post the journal. So that's all about transaction creation. From tomorrow session, we'll discuss the points how we do in the real time. And based on that, we'll start working on the system with a real time implementation approach. So any questions from anyone, please?
Lakshman, in real business, when we, before we start the transaction, we should know what is the expense and what is the asset and retained earnings of the.
When we do the implementation, all accounts will be provided by client only. All the accounts they'll provide in the spreadsheet. How many accounts they have and which account they are using with which nature. Okay, there could be some account called as XYZ. XYZ, the name, we are not aware of it. Internally, they are using. So, they'll be giving the information to us. So-and-so account with this nature we are using. So, that's how we'll be moving all those accounts into application. Okay, there won't be anything where we have to decide that account is which type. How many accounts they are using? What is the nature of account? All that information will be given by client. I'll show you those accounts also, how client will provide and all when we are creating. Okay.
But we have to enter the amount, right?
When we are entering the amount, you no need to give the account type. At the time of creation, see, I entered salaries. I selected account called as salaries. I'm not specifying as expense account, right? Creation time, it is given as expense. I spent 10 lakh salaries. Okay, I paid 10 lakh salaries. What I did, salaries paid. That is the reason I selected salaries account and I entered 10 lakhs. So where we have to provide the salaries account type at the time of salaries account creation within the account segment. When we are entering the record, when we are recording the transaction, you no need to specify the type of account. Only at the time of creation we have to specify one time. That's all. Okay, it's a one time creation. So when you are recording the transaction, you no need to select anything. Just which activity you are performing, the relevant account you select. The relevant account will belongs to specific nature that we create one time when you create those accounts within the chart of accounts. Accounts creation is one time task. Going forward, I mean in the ongoing process, they may add some new accounts into chart of accounts. That's it.
I understand that, but before we start any transaction, they are doing business in like manually, and we have to bring that money. They have asset for like 100,000, so we have to enter. They have asset for 100,000 already, right? So we have to enter that somewhere.
Okay, so you are talking about bringing previous data into Oracle application, that we call as a data conversions, as a part of real-time implementation process. After completing entire course, we have real-time classes, how we do the implementation, what activities we do, there we'll discuss about that. So not only assets, so in payables, they'll have a many suppliers in the current system. Before they come to Oracle application, they may use some ABC or XYZ application, right? There they'll have n number of suppliers, n number of invoices, right? All the information we have to move into this application that we call as data conversion. Okay, I'll explain you on that. That will be done by technical consultants. But functionality point, as a functional consultant, what we have to understand, we will discuss. So that we call as a data conversion, or you can call as data migration, moving the data from legacy system to Oracle applications. In our case, legacy means previous system. Okay.
Okay.
Total data what we move, we classify into two types: master data and transactional data. Master data means suppliers, customers, inventory items, and assets, all we call as master data. Transactional data means supplier invoices, customer transactions. Okay, this all we treat as a transactional data. Okay, I'll touch base on that. Okay, we'll be discussing. Okay, what is the strategy, what process we follow, how the technical people will be bringing the data into Oracle application from other systems. In that process, where we have to involve, what we have to do, these points we will discuss. Any other questions?
Once we close the period, can we reopen it again?
Please don't focus on closing the periods and all, not required. So we have time for that. We will just discuss and we'll do that. I'll show you how to close the periods also. Okay. So because now that is not the focus we are working on. Just it's all about just to create the journal, we open the period. That's all. If you can understand, if your period status is open, we can record the transaction. If period status is closed, we cannot record the transaction. That is enough as of now. Once we start with the real transaction process flow, we'll record the transaction, the payables and other applications. At the time, just when you are opening the periods or closing the periods, you can just raise those relevant points. Now not required at all, because just it's a GL only. The actual transaction should take place in the subledgers.
Okay.
Any questions?
Mr. Lakshman?
Yeah.
After I post the transaction, later at some stage, can I edit or adjust the state?
You cannot.
No.
once you post it, you cannot. After posting, if you find some mistake within that transaction, just you have to reverse it. How to reverse? Through manual process. How to reverse automatically? Those are the separate features we are going to cover as a part of GL.
Okay, that reverse in the sense it's a delete or
just... not deleting, record will remain same. The debits will move to credit, credit will move to debit with the other journal creation. We'll create the opposite journal.
Adjust.
Finally, that will get knocked off. The balances will become zero. We'll discuss. We have reversal methods also, switch debit, credit, chain sign and all. Now we cannot start and discuss those points. Those are separate features. Okay. But just to answer to your question. So if anything after posting, we cannot modify anything within that journal. If you want to change something, you have to reverse and you have to create the journal with the right information. We'll be understanding all these points. These are separate. These all comes under separate features within the GL. I just mentioned in the course curriculum also. We are going to cover those. Almost what are the questions you are asking? All we are going to cover, but just we have time to understand those. We are going in sequence to understand in better way. So, any other questions, please?
Yeah, regarding the currency, it's coming in the header, not coming in the lines. So when I have a foreign currency, how can I deal with that? With two different accounts. Let's say I have a bank in dollar.
Yeah.
And I have to pay
the dollar. In that case, what we do is, say now our functional currency is rupees, right? And if you are going to create the transaction in dollars, you have to define the conversion between INR and USD. One dollar equal to how much INR. Then you will record the dollars in the transaction. Automatically it will be converted into rupees. And when you are recording the journal, we have to select the USD. That we call as foreign currency journal creation in case of GL. In case of AP, foreign currency invoice. In receivables, foreign currency transaction. We are going to cover all those. We have as a part of our course.
Yeah, I'm asking in the same general voucher, can I have two?
No. The main only currency? One. Okay.
Only one. This is my question. Is this only one?
Only even one. You can record the journal in only one currency. That can be your functional or foreign. Only here.
Yeah, got it.
If you record with USD, okay, USD, so system will be adding here your INR balance. It will show your INR balances also. So you will select here USD. Before that, you have to define the conversion. $1 equal to how much INR. Then whenever you enter, say you may enter here $100. Whenever you provide here USD, here debit, it will show as USD only. If you enter $100, the next column, it will show that $100 are equal to how much INR. Automatically, it will show here. Okay.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, you can enter any transaction in one currency, but you can translate, you can convert that same currency balances into other currencies. Entry can be possible with only one currency. That could be your functional or foreign. So any other questions? So no questions, fine. So we'll connect tomorrow same time and we'll start with the real-time implementation approach from scratch, how to understand about business, how we have to bring that business process into the system, what are the naming convention, what are the parameters we consider when we are going to design the solution for any company. We'll discuss all the points more detail level and we'll start doing the complete system configuration and we'll do the transaction. We'll go through all the features. Yeah, please.
Prashant, my question here is, in future, are we going to do intercompany transactions also?
I'll show you how to just manage that transaction between the organization.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll show those transactions now you can. So like company 1000 is going to purchase from company 2000, or company 2000 is providing the services for company 1000. So in that case, how those transactions can be managed in the system, how you can automate. If you specify the system company 1000 expense for company 2000 revenue. In that case, if company 1000 it's expense, there should be liability for that, right? If company 2000 is the revenue, there should be receivables. So those can be automated in the system. How to set up, how that can be automated, I'll show you. I'll be showing you
the journals. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Fine. So that's all for today. We'll connect tomorrow and we'll just continue from here. Thank you all. Have a good day and good night.
Okay, thank you. Good night.
Yeah.
Thank you.